And welcome to today's video. So in this one, I am currently in the car with my stepdad, David, and my best friend since second grade, whose name is Valerie. She's been in quite a few of my vlogs now, but the reason that we are all in the car right now is because we are headed to the Sinclair in Cambridge, Massachusetts, because tonight they are having a very special event, and that is a Pvris concert. So if you don't know who Pvris is, what are you doing with your life? I mean, they're a really, really amazing band, and we've seen them twice together, and I've seen them once before that time. So the once before was in July of 2015. That was the year that I got into them. That was the year I saw them for the first time, and I've been a fan ever since. So when I heard about the opportunity to see them in February of 2018 last year, I invited Valerie, and yeah, this is our third time. It's currently September 17th, 2019. So I'm really excited for tonight, and I know she's very excited too. So yeah, we're on our way there tonight, right now actually, and David is not going to be going with us, unfortunately. I know that would be an amazing time, but he has to work, so he's bringing us, and then when the concert's over, my dad is gonna pick us up because we cannot drive, but that'll change soon. So we're just trying to get our way around right now. So I'm just really excited for tonight because obviously this is my third time seeing them, and there's a lot of changes going on with the band right now. I mean, they're currently working on their third album, right? Their third?
Yeah, they have an EP coming out in October, and then that album's gonna come out in 2020.
It's not an EP, it's not an album, it's an EP that they're releasing first?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are they gonna have all the same songs? I thought they were coming out with an album, not just an EP, but yeah, they're definitely going through a lot right now, going through a lot of changes in the band. So they had their first album, I know the name of it, I just can't think of it right now, White Noise, and then their second album,
All We Know of Heaven, All We Need of Hell.
Yes, she got it, and this new album, this new EP, we don't have the name for yet, but we should find out soon since it's coming out in October, so that'll be a month from now. So we're just looking forward to all of that. So the two songs that they released so far that I guess are going to be on this EP are called Death of Me, which was the first one that came out, and Hallucinations, and both of those are going to be performed tonight along with the rest of their songs. I actually looked it up on the set list. What were you going to say? Did you see the set list?
No.
Okay, I was just gonna ask you because before you got here, I was thinking of vlogging, and then I was like, I'll just wait till you get here so you can be here for everything. But I did look up the set list, and I wanted to tell you guys what it was too, and now you can find out. So, 13, 14, 15. There's gonna be 15 songs in total on the set list. So the first one is gonna be Mirrors. The second one is gonna be Hallucinations, that second new song that I was telling you guys about. Then three, Anyone Else. Four, Fire. Five, Half.
Fire's back on?
Yep.
Wow, it's been so long.
That's gonna be so exciting. So Fire, Half, and then number six, Smoke. Number seven, Heaven. Number eight, Holy. I love how Heaven and Holy are together. We're basically going to church tonight. And then there's number 9, You and I, 10, Eyelids, 11, Winter, so Just Your Luck, it is on the set list. Yes. And then number 12, What's Wrong, 13, Death of Me, and that's gonna be like the main show, and then there's gonna be an encore because they can't leave us hanging without, I mean, they're so amazing, like, you're just gonna leave us hanging right there? No, you can't do that. So for the encore, there's gonna be 14, St. Patrick. I know, that's one of Valerie's favorite songs, definitely, and one of the first that she ever heard when I showed them to her. And then number 15, My House. So yeah, it's gonna be super, super fun, and this is not gonna be like any of their other shows that we've been to before. I mean, I went to Warped Tour, and that was like a festival. It wasn't really like a concert just focused on them, but I had a great time there, and I also had a great time, and Valerie had a great time at their actual tour last year for All We Know of Heaven, All We Need of Hell. And then this time, it's not like a full album tour, obviously, because they haven't released that album, but I guess they came up with the idea to release these two songs and then go on tour with them with some other albums. It's like a little mini tour, and they're doing this because they want to be really intimate with us. I mean, the venues are going to be very small, so this is going to have like a 500 person capacity, maybe 600 at most. So we're really getting up close and personal with them, and I'm really excited because Lynn, the lead singer, is going to be going into the crowd, and Valerie's excited for that too. Yeah. Why don't you show? Yes, I was going to say show off that stuffed animal that she got. So why don't you tell the story of that stuffed animal? How did you get it?
I went to the zoo junior year for my zoo and exotics class, and I was like, oh, maybe I'll just get this because maybe I might go to another concert.
Yeah, and she got a stuffed animal to give to her out of any other animal because that's Lynn's spirit animal. She has the spirit of a lion, literally. Just looking at her perform, you'd know that. So yeah, I just wanted this to be a kind of quick intro, but we just keep talking. So I just want to say I hope you all enjoy watching this video as much as we enjoy making it for you guys, and stay tuned for what happens next. Well, as you can see, Valerie and I are no longer in the car. Right now, we are in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and we are just walking around looking at everything that's going on right now. So, I think my stepdad dropped us off like maybe 5 minutes ago, and we immediately just got out and started exploring. But the thing that was number one on our explorer list was a bathroom because we hadn't peed in a while. So we finally did, and now that our bladders are empty, we can show you a good view of the Sinclair, which we have never been to before, not me or her. And I am like the veteran concert goer. I've been to so many concerts, but here we go. You're about to see, like, right in front of us, there's gonna be a huge line, so you know that's where the line pretty much starts, I'd say, or ends. Either way, you could say it. I'm just super out of breath right now because I just did so much walking. Okay, well, here, would you say this is the start of the line or the end of the line? Like, it's pretty much either. So here's all the people, let me turn it around. All our fellow Paris lovers. And where does the Sinclair actually begin? We're about to find out. It must be this place right here. Oh, it's right here. It's like right in between here. Okay. So this is the Sinclair, 50 Church Street. Yeah, this is definitely the place. So I guess the line started not too long ago, but there's definitely a lot of people. And we really want to get in line, but not right now, because it's a big, nice area to explore, and we're just getting started. So right here is this little plant shop that we came across on our way to the bathroom, and we just couldn't resist coming in here once we emptied our bladders and showed you guys what the line looks like for the Paris concert. So there's a lot of stuff going on here, and it honestly reminds me of the lead singer of Paris, Lynn Gunn, because I feel like she would just love to come in here and look at everything if she hasn't already. I mean, there's just so much going on, and if you look in the background of a lot of her videos, you can see her like playing the piano or singing, and she just has a bunch of plants in her house, which I would too if I had my own apartment. Like, I just love flowers so much. So, I'm really enjoying this place so far. I would honestly love to work in a place like this and be a little old lady, even though I'm only like 18 years old. And she's 19 right here, gonna be 20 soon. Mm-hmm. Well, as you can see, there's a bunch of like green plants over here, and then there's some flowers over here too. I really want to take a bunch of pictures, but let me just give you a quick walkthrough first. So there's some more stuff over here, and then this freezer is just full of stuff to look at. And this is kind of where it ends. What's your favorite flower?
That's a good question. Probably rose.
Same. And it fits me because my middle name is Rose.
Yeah, or maybe sunflowers.
I like sunflowers too, but I feel like roses just have a special place in my heart. Excuse me. we should just take pictures of the flowers, and maybe we can take some cute pictures of ourselves too. Like, I just want to remember every single thing about this day because it's just so perfect. The weather is so nice, and I'm so happy to see you because you're in college right now, and I'm so happy to be seeing Paris again. These cacti are so cute. You see, I may not be in college like Valerie, but I'm still pretty smart. It's not cactuses, it's cacti.
Yeah.
There's just so much to take pictures of. At the moment, Valerie and I have just finished eating our food for the night. So as you can see, we ended up having Subway. So tell them what you got.
I got a spicy Italian with onions, pickles, and olives.
And what I ended up getting was an Italian bread with cheese. Like, that was the name of the bread because it actually had cheese on it. And then I ended up getting American cheese on top of that. And then I had both of those things toasted. And then I had some spinach, banana peppers, onions, olive oil. I had all that. So we are ready to party now. We're ready to use that energy that we just got from that and just have the night of our life. But first, we're still gonna do some more exploring. So obviously we left the plant shop, but we might go back there before the end of the night because honestly, I could stay in there for a while. I really like cooking in there. Yeah, but until then, we're gonna go to Newbery Comics and some other places in the area that we have yet to explore until now. This is actually the building we ordered Subway in. I mean, it looked like it was outside, but it actually wasn't. We just wanted to eat outside because it was nice. But obviously, this Newbery Comics isn't outside either. It's right here. I've never been to this one before, but I have been to one in Boston. And then there's some other places like a tattoo parlor. What do you say? Why don't we go in there before the Paris concert and get Paris tattoos? If only we weren't broke. So, why don't we take a tour of this place with you? There looks to be a lot of stuff in here. Oh wow, look, it's my favorite singer's album that she just came out with. Norman effing Rockwell. I loved every single song on that album. And oh my god, I love how my favorite singer is right next to my favorite band and their new album, We Are Not Your Kind by Slipknot. Amazing. And look! Another band that I love, Korn, with a new album, The Nothing. I've listened to all of these from beginning to end, and I liked every song on that album, every song on that album. I just don't think I liked every song on that album. I mean, I pretty much did except for just one. So, yeah, I guess I've been keeping up to date with all these songs. And look, they're pretty much all in the top 5, 3, 4, and 2. They have so many stuffed animals here. What is that supposed to be, a penguin?
Maybe a pigeon? This one's a budgie.
It almost looks like a parakeet. Does it say?
It might be some kind of finch.
Well, if you know Valerie, you know she definitely likes to look at stuffed animals everywhere that she goes. I mean, she had that animal one just saved up for this occasion, and now she's looking at some over here.
Yeah.
And after this, we'll see what else is in the area. I guess I take back what I said earlier when I was showing off the line. Like, I thought it started at one place and that was the venue, but it turned out to be somewhere different. So like, I filmed this line that was right out here and I went to the very beginning of it, even though there was like a space in the middle. And it turned out that the very beginning was actually a meet and greet line to meet the band. And then there was a space because the actual venue was in the middle, not where I thought it was. And then this part over here, like the longer half, that turned out to be the actual line to get in. So yeah, there's two different lines and they're divided, and in the middle of them is the actual venue. So what I showed you wasn't it. Like I said, I've never been there before, so you can't really blame me. Like, maybe if I went here a few times, I would be like, girl, are you stupid? But I was just like going off by what I was looking at, because who would have thought that like there would be that one line and then a split and then another line, and it would actually like be in between there. Like, it was just so hidden from everything else around here. Like, everything else is just sticking out, and then that was like back there. But the reason that we're not outside with everyone else is because obviously like we did our exploring, but Valerie wanted to charge her phone for a little bit, so that's what we're doing in here in the Dunkin' Donuts. Maybe we'll get something, maybe we won't. Like, we already had Subway, but I always like my coffee. So yeah, we're just chilling right here for now. And I don't know if I showed you my bag. So I have this pink clear plastic bag that I got last month, I think. And ever since, I've just been in love with it because I feel like it's perfect for going to a concert. You know, security can be really tight these days, but this makes it easy for them to check your bag. Like, they see that it's see-through, so they can pretty much trust you, and obviously they still look through it, but I feel like it just makes everyone more at ease when you automatically have a bag like this. But obviously there's nothing wrong with Valerie's bag either. It's perfect for an event like this because it has the Pvris logo on it, which is a P in their little style. And if we did get a Pvris tattoo, like I was talking about earlier, it would be of this logo because that is their main logo, and every member of the band has it. Lynn, Brian, Alex, Brian, and Justin has it too, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Justin is the drummer of the band.
The tour drummer.
Yeah, he is, but he's not really on any of the merch because, like, that's pretty much all he does. He is just, like, there, kind of. But we still appreciate him because he is what makes tour happen. Like, it's really weird that he's not on the merch, but we've just gotten used to it by now.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we get a logo like that, and we haven't yet because we don't have enough money, but someday we just might.
Yeah, I might get like my zodiac symbol as a tattoo.
Yeah, I'll only get that tattoo too. Mine. She is a Scorpio and I'm a Leo, so we could do that and do the Pvris logo. And I have a bunch of other tattoo ideas, but neither of us have ever gotten tattoos before. Only our friend Brendan, and I think he'd get a Pvris logo with us. Like, we're all basically
our own little Pvris. Libra one.
Yeah, he could get that too. Even though Libras are the worst zodiac sign, we still love him.
Yeah, he's an okay Libra.
Yeah, he's my favorite Libra. Honestly, speaking of zodiac signs, like, I actually hate Libras so much, but he's my best friend ever. Like, somehow he just outweighs all those other Libras. He's like the best person ever, and he happens to be one.
He's October, right?
Yeah, I usually tend to like signs born, people born in the second sign, in the second month of their sign, but I just don't like any Libras except for him. But yeah, so we're just chilling here talking about our plans for the night and talking about tattoos, and it should be starting any minute now. It's actually 6:52 now, so 8 minutes.
How we feeling?
Yeah.
all day. I'm some giving you just another second to see it through. I'm giving you one last look. I bet you think that you're lucky, but honey, I'm always on the move. On the moon. You can send me all the roses that you want, boy. You can tell me that you love me when you're bored, boy. If you don't want me to hate you, but it's hard for me to not. Send me all the roses that you want.
There's no secret inside. I try to run, but I can't find my way. Continue.
stuck in a love with the feeling is so untrue. Got no one to blame but myself and you. See the final story through it all true. I'll be convinced to stay. I won't give up now.
I just put out an EP a couple months ago, and it's called Hindsight 2020, and I wrote it within my first year of moving to Los Angeles when I was 19. And it was a fucking crazy time, because I was trying to figure out myself, I was trying to figure out how to do music, I was trying to figure out how to be alone in such a terrifying city, and trying to pretend that I was an adult, even though I had no idea what the fuck I was doing most of the time. So, yeah, none of us do. So, I wrote a bunch of songs about it, including this next one, which is called Fine.
I guess I used it up. This space, there's not enough. I used you way too much.
Thank you.
This next one's called Drugs, and I'm gonna need you guys to help me out on this one, alright? I need you to just act like these, this group of people over here. I need you guys to go crazy, okay? When I say drugs, louder, drugs! That was beautiful, you guys killed it. Thank you. This next one is one of my newer singles. It's called Wish You Make Me Cry. And it's about a guy who's just a little too nice, you know?
We pretend to
Paris for a while, so the fact that we get to open for them is pretty dope. So give it up for Paris and crew for being so awesome. Seriously, you guys are the shit, wherever you are, all of you. All right, I got one more song for you guys. I'm gonna be hanging out after set, probably at merch. I have a shirt that says drugs on it. Who the fuck doesn't want a shirt that says drugs on it? Go get one. And please come say hi. I'd love to meet you guys. All right, this last one's called Stress. Don't
baby, take it all. Thank you.
Cambridge. But realistically, Massachusetts. And most likely, New England. How many of you guys traveled from outside of the state? How many of you guys are in Massachusetts? From either Boston or Cambridge. How many of you are lying? Thank you so much for being here tonight. It feels really good to be back where we all kind of... We didn't grow up in Boston, but all of our family and our friends are here, and we've spent so much time here. It feels good to be here, so thank you so, so much for joining us tonight. Family's cool. Friends are cool. You guys are all our friends.
Team Crunchy.
You're super cool. Speaking in tongues, assuming. for if you have the chance. Very nice. How many of you are joining us for the first time tonight? Well, for those who are returning, welcome back. And for those who are joining us for the first time ever, thank you so much for joining us tonight. This song's called Holy. much. Do you guys like to play games? I'm not playing games! Would you like to play a game? Does anybody know what it might be? What? That's actually not what I was thinking. Okay, we'll play two games. One of them is more a vote, and one of them is a game. Who likes crunchy peanut butter extreme? Who likes creamy peanut butter? That's the game. The next game. If you have a phone, put it in your back pocket. Two more songs to you guys.
totally tell right now, I am no longer at the concert. I'm actually sitting in a Starbucks with Valerie. So it has officially come to an end. And although we didn't want it to end, it had to at some point. So we just tried to make the most of it. I mean, I think we definitely did make the most of it. The first thing that we did when we walked into the venue after getting our tickets scanned was get some merch. So I think I got three things. I got one of these signed posters right here that basically just has all the tours of the intimate shows. I also got a white t-shirt that's like from a picture of them on the set of their music video for their newest song that's out right now called Hallucinations. And then I think I also got another shirt that's just black with Pvris' logo in red. Didn't have the tour dates on the back, which I would have loved, but it still was pretty appealing to me. So yeah, I got those three things, and then Valerie, she also got one of those posters that I was just talking about detailing the tour dates of the intimate shows, and she also got the same shirt that I got, the hallucinations shirt. And then she got a hoodie that's basically representing that song as well. And I would have liked to have a hoodie from Pvris. I mean, I think this is her second one because she has this one too right here. But I think I like this one better. So I wasn't really a fan of the one that I saw before, but that's just my opinion. Some people like it, some people don't. Yep, that's my opinion. Are you getting your stuff out now? Are you sure you want to take it out now? Like, why don't you take it out when we drop you off? Because that's going to be a lot scary.
I
need
to text my friends to come get me.
Your friends to get you?
Yeah. Well, like, from, like, I don't want to walk by myself.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's my first year of college. I'm not trying to get murdered.
Yeah. She just started college and I'm not in college. I think we were talking about that a little bit earlier. I'm not in college because I want to go to beauty school. So I'm just like a full-time YouTuber right now. Well, I'm supposed to be getting a job like this week or next week. I already filled out the application and I basically already got hired. It just needs to process. So I'm looking forward to that. It'll be my second job, and not only my second job, but not only my second job ever, but my second job in this year. So I've been working a lot since the summer, and I'm looking forward to doing more. What did you say? Oh, okay. Yeah, since we're in Starbucks, do you want something? And I'll get something too, but I'll have to look at what they have, because I used to really like Starbucks, but I feel like some of the stuff that I usually go to mostly, my main go-tos that I get are like better at Dunkin' Donuts. So I haven't had them lately, but I have a gift card, so but that's what's going on right now. I think that I should end this video right here. So like I said in the beginning, I hope you all enjoyed watching this video as much as we enjoyed making it for you guys. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!